Please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
For Walmart in India. Just a few months after acquiring 77% in Flipkart, US giant Walmart has opened its second fulfillment center in India. Spread across 45,000 square feet, this fulfillment center in Lucknow will help the retailer speed up operations and deliver goods to Walmart's registered members. These include kirana stores, small businesses, and hotels. CNBC TV18 traveled to Walmart's fulfillment center and best price store in Lucknow and spoke to Walmart India's top boss Krish Iyer about Walmart's aggressive plans in India.
Second fulfillment center in the country. Talk to us about it in terms of what's the kind of expectations of business growth from the fulfillment center.
So this is the second pilot that we are doing as far as the fulfillment center concept is concerned. And the concept is basically that the out-of-the-box sales as well as the e-commerce sales that we have will be fulfilled from this fulfillment center. Our first fulfillment center in Mumbai is gaining good traction and has been doing well. And this would be the second pilot which will cater to the city of Lucknow. And we look forward to a successful pilot as far as Lucknow is concerned.
So talk to us a little bit about this fulfillment center in terms of what's the kind of investment that's gone into it and what's the kind of roadmap in terms of expansion to more fulfillment centers in the country.
In terms of numbers, as you know, we don't talk about the numbers per se, but it's in partnership with DHL. So it's a concept where we won't run it ourselves, and our full logistics partner DHL would run and operate the center. The demand generation part, that is taking orders from kirana stores, small mom and pop stores or offices and institutions, that will be done by our team. I think the key is primarily meeting the needs of kirana stores. And this fulfillment center will help us cover areas which are currently not covered by our Lucknow store and where the members are not able to come to this store because of the distance that is involved. So I believe that it will serve a very important purpose in terms of fulfilling our mission of helping businesses prosper and by focusing on every single member.
So talk to us a little bit about the expansion plans for the fulfillment centers in India. I understand second fulfillment center has been opened on a pilot basis, but through the country I understand that this larger practice of opening these sort of dark stores is something that Walmart will perhaps look at growing in India.
I would not right now comment on the future plans as far as fulfillment centers are concerned, because it's important for us to make the pilots successful. But I do believe that with this concept, we'll be able to penetrate the overall Indian market once it is successful. In the meantime, of course, we have announced our plans to open 50 stores over the next 4 to 5 years, and that is gaining good traction. You know that we have 21 stores, and as we speak, we have signed another 22 sites and 22 properties which are in various stages of approvals and construction. Eight sites, we have broken ground and they are actually under construction, and between this year and next year, we'll end up opening about 8 to 10 stores. So that's exciting.
So if you could break up the kind of non-store sales coming from the B2B e-commerce channel as compared with the overall sales coming from the physical channel.
The B2B e-commerce is picking up very well. Currently, I would say that B2B commerce is a very small portion of our total sales. But what is really important as far as digital is concerned is the digital influence that we experience. Digital should not be measured purely by actual transactions that take place, but in terms of the influence that digital has when the customer goes onto the net and finds out more information about what the store has to offer and the relative prices, the features of products, etc. that influence is big. I would presume that nearly 60 to 65% of the customers do go to the digital medium to find some information or the other about best price and its offering. Actual transactions are still quite limited. They are low. But I think the traction and the momentum is good, and more customers are adopting to the e-commerce medium.
Can we expect about 50% of your sales to come from the B2B e-commerce channel with the kind of influence and the kind of effort that Walmart is putting to grow this kind of pace?
It's all about omni-channel. It's not really about e-commerce versus physical stores, but it's about omni-channel.
So is there a breakup of the sales coming through the channels that you can share?
Broadly, I would say 50% of our business happens in the store and 50% happens outside the box, either through this business development associate or through the e-commerce channel.
Do you expect this to shift further to more e-commerce rather than the physical sales, owing to the kind of efforts that you all are making to ensure that more customers are shopping online, also with a number of fulfillment centers coming up?
I would put it this way. I think while the store sales are also growing, yes, the e-commerce is expected to grow. There may be a minor shift in terms of the overall percentages here and there, but our focus is to grow sales, in-store sales, as well as out-of-the-box sales.
With the kind of, the kind of growing influence on e-commerce, will you perhaps, not go beyond the 50 planned cash and carry stores, because a lot of sales are happening through the online models and a lot of retailers, even in the physical world, are shifting to more and more smaller format stores, more and more e-commerce models?
The wholesale concept is a different concept, and I think the experience of in-store shopping for a member is very different from online shopping. India is large and diverse, and in terms of the opportunity that exists in the entire country, I believe that in the foreseeable future, there will be a good demand from the members in terms of wanting to come to the store and experience the store as well.
So you won't slow down the growth of best price stores?
I don't think we'll slow down the growth of best price stores.
You have about 1 million active customers at your best price stores. And with the growing number of fulfillment centers, do you expect this number to grow exponentially?
I would expect to. Not exponentially, but I would say that in a measured manner, it's important to continue to grow in a very disciplined and focused manner. And we'll continue to stick to our plans.
Is there a number that you can share as to what is the kind of growth rate in terms of member additions that you have?
Every store has about 20,000 to 25,000 members generally. So you can look at that with the number of stores that we'll keep adding. As of now, we have 1 million members in 20 stores. But a new store, when we open, generally has about 25 to 30,000 members.
The other big news that the market and the street wants to know at this point in time is the integration with Flipkart. We do understand that there are some approvals that are pending at this point on the regulatory front. What is the status of these approvals? Do you think it's been sort of delayed? Would you have expected them to come in earlier?
We have announced our investment in Flipkart and we're excited about it. The process is on course. And currently it's pending CCI approval. We believe that the best practices that we have around the world in the area of food and grocery, relating to food safety, relating to responsible sourcing, supply chain, logistics, merchandising, these best practices Flipkart will have access to over a period of time, and it will turn out to be a very beneficial win-win relationship.
You know, at this point in time, there are many stakeholders in the industry, including smaller retailers, associations, who are protesting against this possible merger that is underway. Do you think that that is perhaps delaying the process or could perhaps delay it a bit owing to this opposition?
We are very focused on creation of shared value. Our existing format of cash and carry really serves the small mom and pop stores or the small kirana stores, as you know. We also source a significant amount of our merchandise from small and medium enterprises. Besides, we are totally engaged in sustainable practices when it comes to sourcing from direct sourcing from farms. Just in Lucknow, for instance, the Sunara Prayas program is a great effort to directly source from small farmers, both women farmers as well as other farmers. And we continue to focus also on sustainable energy, environment. Every store that we open creates direct and indirect jobs for nearly 2,000 associates. And so if you look at holistically what we do, I think it's really focusing on creation of shared value, and I believe that that's a big win for everyone, including the economy.
So then you expect approvals to come in a timely manner,
We do expect that approvals will come through.
While we talk about waiting for approvals on the regulatory front, I'm sure there is some integration planning that's happening at the back end. Run us through what sort of plans do you have in terms of integration at this point?
We are not looking at integration. I think the Flipkart will continue to run independently, as our CEO also has said it in the past, that it will continue to remain a board-managed company. And the opportunities that we see is in terms of sharing of best practices with each other in the various areas that I mentioned earlier. So there are no plans for integrating the two businesses for sure.
But when you talk about these best price stores, will these stores also sort of be pickup points for Flipkart products going forward?
The proposal is under approval, and we are not even thinking about some of those things which might be an opportunity in the future. But broadly, I think making sure that the two businesses operate independently and then use leverage with each other in terms of the best practices and that exist, the opportunities that exist, I think that would be the approach.
Talk to us about the whole Indian e-commerce market and the kind of scope that you expect, considering that Flipkart will soon come on board and there is huge competitive intensity that's playing out in the market at this point.
India is a really vast and diverse country, and the consumer is taking to e-commerce extremely well. The growth rates are very high, double digit, and there is opportunity for everyone. So we believe that I think greater number of competitors coming into this field will further help develop the overall ecosystem, and we are bullish about the same.
When you talk about Walmart's India business, I was looking at some numbers. Losses have of course trimmed over the last couple of years. But with Flipkart coming on board, losses perhaps will get bigger and much bigger than what they were in the past. So how would you look at dealing with this kind of situation?
The two businesses have to be looked at separately. Our cash and carry business is a separate business in India, and Flipkart's business is a separate business in India. And as far as the cash and carry business is concerned, we have been making a lot of investment in growth, and when we start investing in growth, I think the focus is more on growing the top line. Our unit economics in terms of each store remain very healthy, and I don't see any concerns on that front.
When you look at pure play numbers as far as Walmart India is concerned, how far is the profitability mark? Because I know losses have trimmed significantly.
we won't talk about the profitability or break-even generally, but as we continue to grow more aggressively, there will be more investments, and it takes time for a business to become profitable. So profitability is not the major focus at this point in time. The focus is on continuing to grow our overall business, our customer base, and what we do in terms of creation of shared value. So the focus is on really building a robust business at this point in time.
Will you be looking at investing into more of cold chain infrastructure for several of these stores and the fulfillment center as well?
Over a period of time, yes, that will be necessary and that will be important. So as we build scale in each of the geographies, I think we'll look at the concept of distribution centers, cold storage, cold chains, etc.
To what tune would you need to perhaps work towards that goal? Do you think there'll be more associations, tie-ups that will be required? Will there be pure play fresh funds coming in to build this kind of infrastructure?
Yeah, so I think just as, for instance, we are doing this partnership with DHL for the fulfillment center. In Mumbai, we did the partnership with KD Logistics. I think we do believe that through partnerships, we can create the necessary ecosystem that is required, and we'll continue to do so. We currently have quite a few partners working with us in various areas, including a lot of startups who are helping us in the overall digital transformation as well.
And in terms of, you know, if you look perhaps 3 to 5 years down the line, where do you see Walmart India in terms of business, in terms of growth? How do you see the India opportunity panning out?
We do expect to double the number of stores in the next 3 years. And we also will grow our top line quite significantly in the next 2 to 3 years. We have, however, a plan for the next 10 years as well in terms of the strategic direction that we have set out. And we'll continue to open about 12 to 15 stores every year as we go along. So this year, of course, we are opening 2 to 3 stores. Next year, we'll open about 7 to 8 stores, and then going forward, slowly increase the number of stores that we open.
When you talk about a healthy top line growth, is there a number in terms of at what rate would you like to grow the top line?
It's a good, healthy double digit growth. I wouldn't talk about precise numbers, but it's a good double digit healthy growth, and we would, as we open more stores, the same kind of rate of growth will continue.
You said that you have a strategic 10-year vision at Walmart. Give us some color as to what you have in store and in mind, and where do you see the Walmart story panning out over the next decade?
The key point is about focusing on our bullseye customer, which is the small reseller or the kirana shops. So we have good plan for really coming up with a good reseller development program, working with our small mom and pop shops in terms of helping them modernize their stores, educating them about planograms, educating them about inventory management, helping them bring down their inventory levels and investments while growing their profits and increasing their returns. So that program has already been kicked off, and will continue to further accelerate as far as the Kirana development or the reseller development program is concerned. That's one of the key parts. The second key pillar, of course, is a continued focus on the B2B e-commerce. The third key pillar is certainly our core business, which is the current cash and carry stores, and continuously innovating as far as the customer value proposition is concerned. So focusing on the customer is the key point there.
And hopefully having B2C open up over the next decade then.
B2C currently is not on the agenda for us. B2C, particularly when it comes to bricks and mortar right now, we believe that the cash and carry concept is a big opportunity and needs focus. So we are really focused on this business at this point in time in a disciplined manner.
When we look at the overall revenue numbers of Walmart Global, $500 billion of revenue, and India is a very small fraction, maybe $500 million. When do you think India business could perhaps double and achieve the kind of scale that you would have anticipated it?
India for Walmart is a key growth market, and I think we will continue to invest in our various businesses, in particularly in the cash and carry concept. We have said that as we continue to grow our number of stores in a very disciplined manner, we'll continue to invest in growing our scale here. So I believe that over a period of time, with this clear focus and good double-digit growth, India will begin to contribute more significantly to the overall Walmart business.
And by when do you expect business to really double in India? Can we expect that over the next 5 to 7 years at least?
From the current level, yes, I think with double-digit growth, we should be able to achieve our target.
$1 billion.
We should be able to achieve
by 2025.
Probably sooner than that. Yeah.
All right. On that note, many thanks for joining us today. It's always a pleasure speaking with you. Thank you so
much. Thank you very much. Thank you very
much. With that is a wrap on this very special show. Thank you so much for watching. We'll be right back.